Allez, bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. So I hope you're doing fine today. It will be in English and in French because it's for beginners. So we'll see exactly how it will go. But then let's say hello to everybody. Stardust is here, bonjour. Yvette est avec nous, bonjour. Yossi, comment ça va? Michel, Jensen, bonjour d'Alsace, bonjour. Attention avec le masque. Hazel, bonjour. Dénora Holson, bonjour à vous. Gloria, bonjour, bonjour. Who else is here? Just I need to scroll. Aziz is here too. Victoria Jacques, comment ça va? Fatima, bonjour aussi. Cosmina est là. Vouslat, bonjour. J. Vincent aussi. Mercurialman. Maggie, bonjour à vous. Hilary is here too. Romand. Melissa is joining us too. Johanna, oui. Bonjour, bonjour à vous. So I hope you're doing really fine. I don't know. Gloria was asking. Yeah, for the school in France, that's it. They're closing again. They're closing the schools. And they will open on the 3rd of May. 3rd of May, so this is the way it will go. It's 3 weeks plus one because there is this vacation. So that's it. Monique nous rejoint. Bonjour Monique. Sancho est aussi. Et Cheryline est là. Okay, we can start right now if you want. Alors, don't forget to click, let's agree on the fact that we need to reach the 100. If that's possible together, it would be so, so great. So let's try to reach it and let's see how it will go. Okay, so every day I remember that I try to invite you to discover a French song. So it's quite good because you can discover a song and at the same time you can work on the lyrics too. So try to find them. And today it's an old song from Daniel Balavoine, who unfortunately passed away a long, long time ago. And it's Mon Fils, Ma Bataille. Was listening to that to get motivated today. So Mon Fils, Ma Bataille from Daniel Balavoine. Please, check first, of course, the song, and it will be in the playlist. I've been adding that every day. So you should find the song there, and then you can look at the lyrics too and try to follow the thing. Try to obviously look at the words if you don't understand everything, and try to sing with the person, because you will see that it's a really, really good exercise for the pronunciation. This is a great, great exercise normally for the phonetics and the way the language will flow. So try to sing on your own with your friends, with your family. It's up to you. Alors, Lynn is joining us. Luciana. Bonjour, Luciana. Sorry, I forgot you. Hima est là. Shona est là aussi. And Aziz is joining us too. So remember that I will introduce some movies too during the lesson. So far, I've been spotting three platforms that you can use abroad and not only in France. So the first one is Arte Boutique. You have here the address. After that, Filmo TV is the second option. And then Orange is also the option. So let me try to first put the thing. I don't know if it will work, but we'll see. And that's it. So now we can start the lesson for real. Allez, comme d'habitude, so like every time now, every day, la phrase du jour. So could you please give me one sentence to sum up your day? So whether it's today, if it is the morning for you, then in that case, give me one sentence to sum up yesterday. Allez-y. I can see that Ice Cubes is joining us too. Bonjour, bonjour, comment ça va? And I'm waiting, of course, for your sentences. Alors, Shona Valentine is the first one and she says, je suis malade. Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Attention, attention, hop là. Ensuite, Victoria Jacques qui dit, hier est passé vite. I mean, is it a good thing or a bad thing? Sometimes it's just a good thing that the day like that. Okay, next. Hey Serge, je me sens espiègle aujourd'hui parce que c'est le poisson d'avril. Oh, vous voulez faire des poissons d'avril? Hey Serge, pourquoi pas? Michel, belle journée de printemps. Eh ben, très bien. Luciana, je suis heureuse parce qu'un de mes cousins qui était interné est rentré hier. Félicitations. Remember, Luciana, that the verb rentrer, you will have to use, in that case, il est rentré à la maison. Hein. It's with être and not avoir. Sanchoe qui nous dit, il fait beau. Magnifique. Aziz qui dit, hier, il a fait beau parce que le temps va bien. Bickert, bonjour à vous. Bonjour, Bickert. Don't forget to click. Hein. N'oubliez pas de cliquer sur le like. Essayons d'avoir les 100. Johanna qui nous dit, ah non, pardon. Victoria Possé, ma journée passe tranquillement en attendant d'avoir mon rythme vital. Eh oui, comment ça se passe? C'est des douleurs, pas de douleurs, tout va bien? Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Victoria? Johanna qui nous dit « Je me sens beaucoup mieux aujourd'hui car il fait un temps superbe là-dehors. Il y a un grand soleil dans le ciel et il fait vraiment chaud et agréable. » Eh ben oui, I'm just like you, Johanna. When it's shining, I'm quite good. When it's grey, I feel down. Hilary, je suis allé à la bibliothèque. Ah ben ça, c'est chouette. Fatima, hier, j'ai réussi à rester ici à plein temps. Merci, mais je vous en prie. Louai qui nous dit, il fait mauvais aujourd'hui. Ça, c'est terrible. Yossi, ma belle-mère est chez nous et c'est très agréable. J. Vincent, hier, j'ai travaillé avec du fil, commençant à enfiler la chaîne sur le nouveau métier à tisser. Très bien. Gloria, la journée a été fabuleuse. Wow. Modeste. Modeste, Gloria. Difficult to beat. Right? It's difficult to beat. Fabuleux, c'est difficile de faire mieux. Ali, bonjour Ali, comment ça va? Don't forget to click, Ali, please. Mélissa, merveilleuse journée avec mon copain Louis. Eh bien, bonjour à Louis, Mélissa, bonjour. Cosmina, toute la vie et la sève qui, pendant des longs jours d'hiver, ont frissonné silencieusement à l'intérieur des arbres, ont jailli maintenant sous forme d'inflorescence blanche et rose. Magnifique. En les enjolivant comme s'ils seraient des mariés. Ouais. might not be the first thing that the nature want to do. But then, Stardust, je suis allé me promener et tout commence à fleurir maintenant. Le soleil était très chaud sur ma peau. Alors, je suis dans le parc et j'ai regardé les enfants jouer. C'était une belle matinée. Bexam, bonjour Bexam. Lynn, hier, nous avons entendu qu'il y a un autre verrouillage à venir ici. Ouais, il y a des verrouillages partout. Bickert, je suis allé un jour un peu monotone, comme d'habitude. Ah, ben ça arrive, ça arrive. Andy, hier, j'ai travaillé dans mon jardin. J'ai coupé la pelouse. Charare, je me suis promené avec mon fils. Ça, c'est sympathique. Vouslat, il n'y a pas de soleil aujourd'hui, mais je me sens bien. Et c'est l'anniversaire de ma mère. Vouslat, anniversaire égal. Alors, c'est formidable. L'anniversaire de votre maman. Bon anniversaire à votre maman, Vouslat. Denora, il pleut beaucoup. J'ai ouvert les fenêtres et les portes pour faire entrer la zone. J'aime beaucoup l'air, peut-être. Oui, pour rafraîchir, peut-être un petit peu. Luciana, il est rentré hier. Ouais. Olaya, bonjour, bonjour, Olaya. Monique, hier, j'ai parlé en français avec mon ami dans Google Meet. Il vit au Congo et il a dit que je parle bien français. Mais bien sûr, Monique, bien sûr. Et bravo, bravo d'avoir essayer et d'avoir réussi à parler français. Cosmina, vous pourriez dire que oui, oui. I thought you were describing the thing on the video, hein, Cosmina. Ali, ça va bien. Roman, aujourd'hui, j'ai travaillé toute la journée avec une tâche de paralysie et comme vous le savez, la semaine prochaine est post-clof. Je ne peux pas être occupé. Ah, c'est Pâques. Je ne peux pas être occupé tout le temps avec des tâches cette semaine, d'accord. Yesero, bonjour Yesero. Ensuite, Surya, how to learn le and la for things. Well, you need to remember the gender of the words when you start to encounter them. And then I've been making some videos, Surya, regarding certain categories. But then, well, basically, watch the videos and after that, you know, come back. Yesero, hier, je suis allé au supermarché et j'ai acheté des fraises délicieuses et merveilleuses. Cassandra, bonjour Cassandra, comment ça va? Allez, on y va. Okay, let's start with dictée de mots, as you can see. Well, it's the usual exercise that we tend to do on a regular basis. So I will just read some words and you've got to write them. Of course, try to write them properly. We'll start with the first one. So these words, in fact, today will be verbs, d'accord? So no trick there. Well, I hope I wanted to put verbs, so I think it will be only verbs. So the first one. Attention, s'absenter, s'absenter. Try to write it, please. Alors, Chérilie, nous avons découvert un mécanisme que nous appellerons glutexo. You will call it like that just to make it more simple. Donc dans la graisse fessière, aha, expliquant la clairance rapide du glucose chez les souris grasses. Donc ça veut dire que vous commencez à trouver la solution. Eh ben bravo. Alors, I'm looking at your things. Yes, it's quite good. Remember that s'absenté. Okay, well, that's the way it was supposed to be. Now you have it, hein? S'absenté. Well, it's a pronominal verb, so in that case, it's S apostrophe. You put the apostrophe because normally it should be se. Chérie, really? It was Poisson d'Avril? You should not say that. Alors, let me try to concentrate now. So, but then you remove the you put the apostrophe, and then you go for absenté. Absenté, remember, A-B-S-E-N-T-E-R. B-B-B, ab. But then in that case, you will pronounce it a bit more like p-p-p, absenté. If you listen, most of the cases, people will pronounce like if it was a P and not a B. You don't really say absenté, but you say absenté. That's it. Numéro 2. Numéro 2, I hope you're ready, because the number 2 is conquérir. Conquérir. Allez-y. Alors, Fiona is joining us. Bonjour Fiona, comment ça va? Alors, le verbe, the verb that we're looking for was, in fact, conquérir. So, you write it quite well, in fact. So, it's quite good. C-O-N-Q-U-E, accent aigu, R-I-R. So, this is really good. Numéro 3. Numéro 3. So, same thing here. It will be a verb. And the verb is caresser. Caresser. Allez, write the verb, please. Jack, is there someone standing behind you? Ben non, I hope. I hope there is nobody, because if there is somebody, then there is a problem. Might be a murderer. Oh, then Jack, you wanted to play with me. Yeah? You wanted to make this Poisson d'Avril, I guess. Alors, caresser, caresser, you're right, it's C-A-R, only one, R-E-S-S-E-R. So it's a regular verb from the first group. Allez, let's continue with numéro 4. Numéro 4, on y va, same thing here. I will read it twice. Examiner, examiner, allez-y. Nuage sain. Et oui, une auréole, Gloria, une auréole. Oui, oui, oui. Saint-Vincent. Il y en a deux. Hein. We've got two Saint-Vincent in France. Alors, examiner, examiner. Well, you write it like that. It's not really tricky, this one. I just wanted to check if it was okay for you. So, E-X-A-M-I-N-E-R. Hein. So, this one is simple. And let's finish with number 5. And number 5 is... And I will say it only once, exécuter. Allez-y. No, Sherlyn. No, the thing is that today I just forgot. I totally forgot that the Poisson d'Avril. I mean, we woke up with Nicolas. We were quite late, so it was mostly focused on let's try to be on time for school. And so that's the way it is. So he didn't have even the time to make this Poisson d'Avril to put on my back. Allez, exécuter, oui, you write it quite well. Be careful, Victoria Jacques, and don't be too generous with the accent. Only one is enough. X, accent aigu, C-U-T-E-R. Extremely irregular from the first group. J'exécute, tu exécutes. Il exécute, nous exécutons, vous exécutez, ils exécutent. Extremely simple to conjugate. Alors, Stella is joining us. Bonjour Stella, comment ça va? Sherlyn, quel dommage. Well, no, because the day is not over. So now, he doesn't suspect it, and this is when it will come. It will come to him big time. I will make several after the lesson. Allez, we continue with the questions we've been starting that a few days ago. So this is a sentence. Elle pense juste à son travail. So I would like you to, as we did previously, ask two questions. The first one should be the formal one. So basically, the way it should be done if you need to do the inversion and things like that. So the proper way to ask the question. The second one, you will in fact use est-ce que, just to make it less formal, and you will see that, I mean, the order won't change that much if it doesn't change at all, in fact. So, formal and then informal. Please, two questions. Allez-y. Alors voilà. So let's have a look at now the first two questions, and you will see that it will be quite important because after that we will just reproduce the same structure. So in that case, as you can see, the verb penser, elle pense, is structured with the preposition à. So it means that we will have to reuse this preposition in our question. So in the question, we will start with the preposition à. After that, remember that when we put some prepositions, we cannot put the que that normally we put for the what concept. So you will use quoi instead. À quoi. Then after that, you put your verb, pense. Then you should put the subject right after. Elle. And we saw that because this a funny thing, to make it beautiful and easier to pronounce, we will have to put this T between the verb pense and elle, because you've got two vowels. À quoi pense-t-elle? D'accord? So this is the first structure, I mean the formal, normal way. Then the second one. We will reuse exactly the same preposition because, once again, the verb penser will be structured here with the preposition à, so we need to put that in the question. À quoi? Then we squeeze the est-ce que? D'accord? À quoi est-ce que? Then we put the subject and the verb. As you can see, the subject is L. So it starts with the vowel. So it means that your E from the que will have to go away and you will put the apostrophe. À quoi est-ce qu'elle pense? First one, à quoi pense-t-elle? Second one, à quoi est-ce qu'elle pense? So now, I won't trick you because basically all the other sentences that we will see will be exactly with the same logic. D'accord? It will be with the preposition à, and the rest will you will see. I will of course put other verbs. Sentence here. Elle rêve à son prochain appartement. Same thing here. Rêver à. So it means that I want to have this preposition à in your two questions. So go for it now. Give me the two questions, please. First the formal and then the informal. Allez-y. Hilary, where do you put just in the question? You don't really need to put just in the question because basically you first start with the question, but then the person is answering with just to emphasize it. So basically it should not be in the question normally. Alors, oui, d'accord. Hein? So it's exactly the same logic that we have now. So à quoi, we start with the preposition and then quoi, then the verb rêve, then the subject elle, and between the two, you will put the T just to make it, smoother to pronounce. À quoi rêve-t-elle? And then the second option, the less formal one, à quoi, same beginning, est-ce qu'elle rêve. À quoi rêve-t-elle? À quoi est-ce qu'elle rêve? Allez, let's continue with the numéro 3. Numéro 3, regardez, elle joue à la roulette. Elle joue à la roulette. Same logic. And ask the two type of questions, the formal one and the informal one. Alors, Mercurial Man by tradition here, April Fools only occur in the morning. I don't really care. I will do it in the evening until midnight, 1 minute before. Alors, let's have a look at the question. So the first one, à quoi, one more time, the verb joue, and then your subject, elle, one more time, we've got two vowels, so we will put the T between the two. À quoi joue-t-elle? D'accord? First option. Then the second option, the less formal one, à quoi, we still continue, start with the à quoi. After that, est-ce que elle joue? Same thing here, que, and then elle, you will have to drop your and put the apostrophe. À quoi joue-t-elle? À quoi est-ce qu'elle joue? D'accord? Allez, on continue, let's continue. Number four, elle s'intéresse uniquement à sa vie. Elle s'intéresse uniquement à sa vie. Allez-y, write the question, please. Alors, je regarde, Cosmina est la première, you're the first one as usual. Amina, quoi s'intéresse-t-elle? Oui, d'accord. Johanna, juste après, Yossi, ok. So it seems that everybody is quite okay with the structure now, no problem. So, à quoi, one more time. Then we put the verb, s'intéresse, then we put the subject, elle. Same scenario here, you can see that you've got two close to each other, so we'll put the T between the two. À quoi s'intéresse-t-elle? D'accord. Hilary wants to squeeze the the adverb each time. So it's the proper place if you want. If you want to really ask with the adverb, obviously you should put it after the verb, but in that case, the subject should come between. Hein. So, à quoi s'intéresse-t-elle uniquement? D'accord. And then the second one, à quoi est-ce que... Subject, elle, then the verb s'intéresse. À quoi est-ce qu'elle s'intéresse? Allez, let's finish with numéro... Ah ben non, that's it. That's it for this one. I don't know if you used to like Guillaume Depardieu, so was the son of Gérard Depardieu, and I think he was really a good actor, but unfortunately he passed away a few years ago, but I think he was really good. So Versailles is a movie where Guillaume Depardieu is playing. Allez, la personne du jour. La personne du jour, aujourd'hui, c'est Mimi Mati. So I don't know if you know Mimi Mati. She's quite popular in France, and she's been quite popular for, well, quite many years now. So let's discover Mimi Mati in a few points. So the first one, and it's here. Michel Mati, dite Mimi Mati, est une humoriste et actrice française née le 8 juillet 1957 dans le 7e arrondissement de Lyon. Michel Mati, dite Mimi Mati, est une humoriste et actrice française née le 8 juillet 1957 dans le 7e arrondissement de Lyon. Allez-y. Alors, Victor Blanco. Ah, we've been covering this day between... The concept is the euphony. So basically it means that it must, the language must be extremely fluid when you say it, when you talk. So basically it means that when you have two vowels next to each other, this is called hiatus. It means that it's extremely difficult in French. So whether you need to remove something, and in some cases it's not possible, you don't touch the verb, and then it would be strange to touch the subject. So you need to add something. This is the reason why you've been adding the T, just to make it more smooth when you pronounce it. This is the reason. I've been making some videos regarding this euphony concept, so you might want to watch them. Alors, let's have a look at the things we were looking for. The first one is DIT. Remember that you will have to write it D-I-T-E. Basically, you put the feminine form, the E, because it's Michelle. It's a lady. Michelle could be a man, but not written like that. Actrice. Actrice is the feminine form of acteur, and you write it A-C-T-R-I-C-E. Actrice, d'accord? And then after that, it's the month. Remember that in French, we don't put the capital letters for the month, so it should be in small letters. So it's J-U-I-L-L-E-T. And you pronounce it juillet. Remember, juillet. That's it. So this is the way it should be pronounced. Let's look at the second thing regarding Mimi Mati. On y va. Elle est notamment connue pour avoir fait partie du trio comique Les Filles avec Michel Bernier et Isabelle Botton dans les années 1980. Elle est notamment connue pour avoir fait partie du trio comique Les Filles avec Michel Bernier et Isabelle de Botton dans les années 80. Write the missing words, please. Alors, Poumima is joining us. Bonjour, Poumima. Ramses joining us too. Dawar Vanch is here too. Bonjour, bonjour. Alors, let's have a look at the things we're looking for. So the first one is the verb avoir. Avoir should be okay. Normally, you write it A-V-O-I-R. And it's quite interesting because when you look at the structure, avoir fait together, this is something that we saw, we discussed about that a few weeks ago. I guess it was this infinitif passé. Hein? This is this infinitive passé form. After that, comique. Comique is an adjective. This adjective will be exactly the same whether it's masculine or feminine. And you will write it C-O-M-I-Q-U-E. Comique. And the last thing, it's année. Année in that case, as you can see, we've got the article, the plural form. Les, so année should be in the plural form. A N-N-E, accent aigu, E and S. So, les années 80, in fact, we're talking about from 80 to 89, the 80s. Voilà, allez, on continue avec le numéro 3 concernant Mimi Mati. Elle devient extrêmement populaire avec son rôle de Joséphine Delamar dans la série Joséphine, ange gardien, produite depuis 1997. Elle devient extrêmement populaire avec son rôle de Joséphine Delamar dans la série Joséphine, ange gardien, produite depuis 1997. Please write the missing words.
Thank you.
Alors, oui, I can see that everything seems to be quite okay, in fact. So the first thing is populaire. So populaire, it's an adjective. It will be exactly the same form, whether it's masculine or feminine. And then you will write it P-O-P-U-L-A-I-R-E. Populaire. The other thing, it's a noun, it's a substantive, and it's série. Série, it's always in a singular form when we're talking about a series. We don't say des séries, but we say une série. S-E, accent aigu, R-I-E. And then the last thing, it's depuis. Depuis, you write it D-E-P-U-I-S. Depuis. Let's have a look at the numéro 4. Numéro 4, on y va. Elle fait également partie de la troupe des enfoirés dont elle est la marraine depuis 2008. Elle fait également partie de la troupe des enfoirés dont elle est la marraine depuis 2008. Please write the missing words. Alors, Hems, well, I'm happy if you enjoyed the content of the website. I am still working on the update, the upgrade, so I will upgrade the curriculum, but it will come little by little, but still I'm starting to recording it, so. Allez, on regarde ensemble. Let's have a look at the three things that we're looking for. The first one is the verb faire. Remember that in that case, you have to conjugate it in the third person of the singular present. So it's elle fait, F-A-I-T. After that, la troupe. La troupe, so you can see that it's a feminine noun. You write it T-R-O-U-P-E. Remember that you don't really pronounce the E, the final E, that strong. So troupe. And then after that, it's don. Hein? Don, remember that you should write it D-O-N-T. Don. And that's it for Mimimati. So now you know her. If you didn't know her before, well, that's it. French people know her. Everybody knows her. So you can discuss about her after that. Allez, it's been a while, it has been a while, la dictée de nombre. We used to do it every day, but then we did other things, and now I think it would be good to go back to it, at least for this level. So remember how it goes, I will just read the number, and then it will go by digit. So now it's the first one, so it means that we will have only one digit. So I will read it only once. 3. D'accord, so it seems to be extremely simple for everybody. Félicitations, c'est 3. Hein? 3, it's not really tricky. Let's have a look at number 2. So number 2 means that we will have 2 digits. And here it comes. I will read it maybe only once and we'll see exactly how it goes. D'accord? 94. Try to write it. Alors, oui, hein, oui, it seems to be so simple for everybody. Ah, Aziz, be careful, it was not 24, but it was 94. So, 94, and remember, 9 and 4. So, 90, 90, and then 4, 94. So, let's have a look at number 3. Number 3 means that we will have 3 digits, and this time, I guess I will read it 2 times. 612. 612. Write it, please. Allez, Denise entre en scène. J'espère qu'elle est, elle est bien équipée avec... Ah non, c'est un bol. C'est un bol de café, Denise. C'est pas une tasse. Alors, effectivement, 612. Félicitations. So it's quite good. Hein? So 600... 600 and then 12, 12, 612, 612. Voilà. Allez, let's continue. Numéro 4, numéro 4. So let's try to be logical. It means 4 digits. In that case, I will read it twice. 8603. 8603. Allez-y. Alors, oui, très très bien, effectivement. Hein, so, 8000, 8000, 600, 600, 3, 3. So, 8603, it will be 8603. 8, 6, 0, 3. Allez, on continue. Numéro 5. So, number 5 will be with 5 digits. Same thing here, I will read it. 2 times 36519. 36519. Please write it. Alors, Omar, bonjour, excusez-moi, je ne vous avais pas vu, sorry I didn't see you. Alors, regardons ça ensemble. 36, 36, 1000, 1000. 36,000, 36,000. 500, 500. 19, 19. You combine the whole thing. 36,519. 36,519. Et voilà. Merci beaucoup. Félicitations. And please, please, please don't forget to, yes, like on the, click on the like button. Thank you very much. Raymond Depardon is a great, great director. He's doing only documentaries. And if you get the chance to look at them or to watch them, I really, really invite you to do so because they are extremely important. And it's a great way to discover French society as well. Allez, à vous la parole, à vous la parole. Regardez. Alors, question. It's a question. Est-ce normal d'aller chercher son amoureux ou son amoureuse à l'aéroport et pourquoi? So, do you think that it's normal to go and pick up your lover at the airport and especially why? Write me one sentence to tell me what do you think about that. Allez-y. Ice cubes, the level is beginner. Remember, for the beginner's level, it's only max 5. And after that, for the intermediate, we've got all the thing. And for the advanced, it's the same. We go till the million. Alors, je regarde, I think you're typing, you're extremely motivated to write me a beautiful sentence, so I won't rush you, take your time. If you didn't yet, click on the like button, it is now or never. Alors, ça commence. Aziz is the first one and says, mais oui, parce que je ne vois pas la personne depuis longtemps. Chris qui dit, oui, c'est normal. Et celle qui dit, c'est normal d'aller chercher un amoureux à l'aéroport parce que c'est romantique. Gloria qui dit, mais oui, bien sûr. J. Vincent qui dit, pourquoi ne peuvent-ils pas prendre un taxi? Bickert qui dit « La question est très difficile. Je ne sais pas dire si c'est normal ou pas normal. » Yossi « À mon avis, ce n'est pas normal d'aller chercher à l'aéroport, mais ça peut arriver par hasard. » Fiona « Je vois des émojis devant le nom à de tout le monde. Qu'est-ce que j'ai manqué? Comme si mon amour ne devait pas me chercher à l'aéroport. Fiona, ah, les emojis, ah, c'est parce que c'est des personnes qui sont membres de la communauté. Il faut cliquer sur join. You need to click on the join if you want to be a member of the community. And this is how you will have your little icon and your name will be green. Hilary, oui, parce que je veux avoir mon mari dès que possible. Victoria Thomas, oui. On est amoureux et on veut son amour rapidement. Victoria Jacques, ouais. Si tu as le temps, c'est un beau geste. Avec des fleurs, bien sûr. Alberto, oui, parce que ça démontre notre amour. Stardust, mais bien sûr, il est important de venir chercher votre amoureux à l'aéroport. La première fois que vous vous rencontrez à nouveau et d'une beauté indescriptible. C'est une belle façon de montrer votre amour lorsque vous récupérez votre amoureux. J'aime bien récupérer. Cassandra, à mon avis, je pense que c'est très important d'aller chercher ton amoureux parce que vous avez reçu un cadeau de leur part. Ah, c'est ça, c'est très intelligent. Denora, c'est romantique de retrouver son amoureux à l'aéroport, mais bien sûr. Victoria Posse, à ce moment, ce n'est pas normal, car il vaut mieux qu'il y ait peu de déplacements. C'est vrai, Victoria, on ne va plus chercher maintenant, c'est fini, mais vous êtes vacciné après, hop, vous pouvez aller n'importe où. Ça va être formidable, Victoria. Vous avez de la chance. You're so lucky. Yesero, oui, c'est tout à fait normal, car vous laissez votre amoureux ou votre amoureuse et vous devez le ramener. Roman, oui, pourquoi pas? Parce que nous montrons à quel point cette personne est importante et dans nos vies. Et donc, nous devons montrer notre amour à travers les petites choses. Et oui, Cosmina, voulez-vous dire attendre votre amoureux ou amoureuse à l'aéroport quand il revient d'un voyage? Oui, c'est très normal. Oh là là, avec l'adverbe très normal, hein. Comment c'est possible d'être plus normal que normal? Ah, c'est une bonne discussion. Vouslat, oui, c'est très normal d'aller chercher son amoureux ou amoureuse à l'aéroport parce que cela montre qu'on l'aime beaucoup. Chériline, pas s'il voyage avec vous ou s'il n'est pas la destination. Ah, bien sûr. Ce serait bizarre d'aller le chercher autre part. Fatima, si vous avez le temps, pourquoi pas? D'accord. Johanna, oui, bien sûr. C'est une question de respect et de tendresse envers celui ou celle qu'on aime et qu'on considère comme la meilleure partie de notre vie. Il y a encore bien des femmes qui apprécient ça vraiment. Et les hommes aussi. Hein. Dans les deux sens. Johanna, dans les deux sens. C'est l'égalité des sexes. Bickert, à mon avis, les gens peuvent rencontrer leurs amoureux à l'aéroport. Omar qui dit c'est pratique et romantique aussi. Monique, oui, je pense que c'est romantique et mystérieux, car c'est possible de faire un nouveau voyage. Vous le prenez, allez, hop, on y va, pourquoi pas. Allez, merci beaucoup. Allez, trouvez un mot, et on y va. S'il vous plaît, trouvez un mot qui commence avec AG. So try to find one word that will start with the letters A and G. Allez-y. Alors, Stardust, un agneau, eh oui, oh, c'est mignon, un petit agneau, c'est tellement mignon. Bickert, l'agriculture, féminin. Fiona Adams, agréable, très bien. Hessel, agréable aussi. Vouslat, une agence, très bien. Johanna, peut-être une agence aussi, hein, maybe that's what you wanted to write. Aziz, un agent, très bien. Yossi, agir, verbe du... Deuxième groupe, j'agis, tu agis, il agit, elle agit, nous agissons, vous agissez, ils agissent, elles agissent. Victoria Thomas, agir aussi, Alberto, agir aussi, Hillary, agacé. Il est pas mal ce verbe-là, agacé, il m'agace. Omar, agnostique, comme on a vu, effectivement. Roman qui nous dit l'âge, masculin, un âge. Chériline, oh là là, alors attendez. Agamaglobulinémie. Wow, encore une fois, Chériline, you need to explain, because I don't know this word. Sorry about my ignorance regarding all the words that you offer. Aziz, agréable, only one up. Victoria Jacques, une agrafe. Cosmina Bellou, agreste. Lynn, agile, masculin, féminin. Denora, un agnostique aussi, une agnostique. J. Vincent, agité. Fatima, agréé. Victoria Possé, des agrumes, effectivement. Cassandra, agressif. Et Yesero qui dit agressé. Alors, féminin, oui, c'est ça, féminin singulier. Allez, la question du jour, la question du jour. Avez-vous peur que quelqu'un vous espionne avec votre webcam? Pourquoi? Avez-vous peur que quelqu'un vous espionne avec votre webcam? Et pourquoi? I've been hearing this thing for so long now, and I didn't hear anybody who had some difficulty with the spying thing with the webcam. So I don't really know. Tell me, est-ce que vous avez peur que quelqu'un vous espionne avec la webcam? Et pourquoi? Allez-y, une phrase. Alors, je regarde, c'est Victoria Jacques qui attaque. Oui, tout le temps, parce qu'il y a des hackers partout dans le monde. Yeah, but did you hear any stories of friends who had some difficulties? I never heard any stories about friends who were hacked with their webcam. This is the thing. And I'm not sure if it's really something that happens a lot. Cosmina qui nous dit non. Par contre, cette personne doit avoir peur parce que elle risque des mauvais rêves dans la nuit. Je dis ça parce que je n'ai pas visité mon coiffeur il y a quelques mois. Ça, c'est bien. Ah oui, on peut faire peur. On fait peur aux hackers. We can scare them. J. Vincent, c'est possible, mais je garde ma webcam dans une boîte lorsqu'elle n'est pas utilisée pour une réunion. Hems, est-ce que c'est une boîte en métal, J. Vincent, ou une boîte normale, ou une boîte comment? Hems, parce que l'ordinateur est espionné par le gouvernement. Oui, peut-être. Aziz, oui, j'ai peur parce que mon mari est magnifique. Ou ma femme. Ah ouais, il faut protéger son mari ou sa femme, c'est normal. Omar, je n'ai pas peur que quelqu'un m'espionne parce que je contacte les personnes que je ne contacte pas les personnes que je ne connais pas. Yesero, oui, j'ai bien peur car j'ai vu un rapport qui détaille comment quelqu'un peut pirater votre ordinateur et prendre le contrôle. Alberto, non, parce que je ne suis pas en train de faire quelque chose d'irrégulier. Bah oui, oui. Moi, je suis un peu comme Alberto. Fiona, oui, j'ai peur que quelqu'un m'espionne avec la webcam parce que ma vie personnelle peut être en danger. Hilary, oui, parce que quelqu'un saurait ce que je mange devant l'écran. Ah ben moi je bois ma boisson caféinée. Eh oui. Monique, oui, parce que c'est mon intimité qu'il va utiliser pour rire et beaucoup sur internet. Oui. Athé, oui, c'est pourquoi ma webcam a un autocollant. Ah ah. Chris, j'en ai peur. C'est pourquoi j'ai trop grand peur, je ne sais pas. Oui. Hessel, j'ai peur avec l'espionnage de la webcam parce que les chefs des entreprises les recouvrent. Oui. Luciana, oui, c'est dangereux parce que la liberté individuelle est fondamentale. Victoria Possé, je n'ai pas peur parce que je pense que personne ne m'espionne. Je n'y pense pas. Ensuite, Denora, non, je ne pense pas que je suis très importante et je ne veux pas être paranoïaque. Oui. Moi, c'est pareil. Ah, j'ai pas envie de commencer à avoir peur. I don't want to stress in advance about these things. Brahim, bien sûr, parce qu'il y a des choses secrètes. Cassandra, oui, bien sûr, j'ai peur parce que j'ai regardé un documentaire à ce sujet. Ça m'est arrivé à beaucoup de gens. J'utilise toujours un autocollant pour couvrir ma webcam si je ne l'utilise pas. Ice Cubes, non, parce que je n'utilise pas une webcam au travail. Cheryline, oh oui, attends Cheryline, après Cheryline. Stardust, ma webcam est toujours fermée par un ruban adhésif. Il est arrivé que la webcam soit allumée sans que je l'utilise. Oh, la webcam est très facile à pirater. L'outil pour le faire peut être téléchargé. Waouh, Stardust, je ne fais confiance à aucune webcam. Très bien. Johanna, je pense qu'il est, c'est une question d'intimité. Ben oui, je n'aime pas être espionné, ni même pendant mes classes de langue. Paraît-il qu'il est illégal de faire ça quant aux écoles, mais enfin. Oh. Romande, mon Dieu, c'est maintenant que tu as entendu parler, maintenant j'ai eu un peur. Mais je dois faire attention à ce que la CIA ne m'espionne pas. Yossi, oui, je couvre toujours ma webcam, hein, parce qu'on ne sait pas. Ah, attendez, parce qu'on ne sait pas qui entre dans mon ordinateur ou le portable. Victoria Thomas, oui, mais ma vie est tellement simple et pas intéressante. Oui, pareil pour moi. Maybe I should put a sticker here. It took me 13 years to open the webcam to do some videos. Fatima, oui, car j'ai des bigoudis dans les cheveux. Moi, je ne peux pas. Je devrais peut-être en mettre pour attirer les gens. Lynn, moi aussi, je n'en sais rien. Vous, Slat, oui, c'est comme c'est techniquement possible, il faut fermer la webcam avec une bande noire. Gloria, je pense que toute la technologie pose des questions. Cheryline, ma superviseure n'a même pas besoin de m'espionner avec ma webcam. Mon bureau est directement devant son bureau, juste en face. Merci beaucoup. So this one is quite interesting because it is with Jane Birkin, but then the movie is made by her. So if you really want to discover her world, I mean the way she can produce and make a movie, so you could discover Les Boîtes. Allez, les questions. Numéro 1, so we'll continue exactly in the same way as we did at the beginning of the lesson. But then remember that in that situation, well, as you can see, elle aime parler de sa vie. You can see that in that case, we are using the preposition de. So obviously it will impact the questions that we will make. One more time. Green box, the formal way to ask the question. Blue box, I'm expecting to have the informal way to ask the question. So go for it. Regardons what you've been writing so far. It's quite good, in fact. So we'll do exactly as we did previously. So previously it was with the preposition a, so it was à quoi. But in that situation it will be, well, the preposition de. The rule is still the same. We're not putting que, but we have to put quoi, d'accord? So de quoi. So this is the first part. And then M, of course, the verb. One second, I need to press on my button here. So the verb aimer, aime. After that, you put the subject, elle, and you finish with your infinitive. Between M and L, one more time, we'll have to add the T because you've got two vowels. So, de quoi aime-t-elle parler? Second option, we'll start exactly the same way. De preposition, we put de quoi, and then est-ce que elle, we drop the E from the que, we put the apostrophe, aime parler, we just put the same structure, subject, verb. De quoi est-ce qu'elle aime parler? First one, de quoi aime-t-elle parler? Second one, de quoi est-ce qu'elle aime parler? Allez, on y va. Numéro 2, we'll continue, so normally it should be quite fast now. Elle discute souvent de choses artificielles. Elle discute souvent de choses artificielles. Écrivez les deux questions. Give me the two questions, please. Formal and informal. Alors, Soukania is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour. Qu'est-ce qui se passe, Ice Cube? Trop long à écrire toutes les phrases. Just because you've got the little phone, non? Well, you should use the computer, baby. Ah, d'accord, je suis paresseuse. So it's another thing. Laziness. La paresse. Alors, let's have a look at your things. So the first one is, yeah. De quoi discute elle souvent, if you want to put the adverb in the end. De quoi discute-t-elle souvent? De quoi est-ce qu'elle discute souvent? So I'm looking at your things. Everything seems to be quite good. So I won't spend too much time explaining because everything is quite okay. Elle a besoin de l'aide des autres. Elle a besoin de l'aide des autres. Same thing here. Can you give me the two questions? Alors, je regarde, I'm looking, it's starting to arrive, so it's, in fact, it's, whoops, it is quite good. Where is it? It was not there? It's possible. This is the technical thing that we've been having, one per lesson, this is the way it should be. No, is it here? Alors, let's have a look. Okay, so elle a besoin de l'aide des autres. So I don't have it on my screen, so I will give it to you like that. De quoi a-t-elle besoin? That's exactly what you've been writing, and it's quite good. De quoi est-ce qu'elle a besoin? So we agree, it's in fact quite good. So no need to stress on that. Look at numéro 4. Elle s'intéresse... What? Oh my God, I'm totally lost now. Okay. Voilà, that's it. Elle profite de toutes les opportunités. Elle profite de toutes les opportunités. Allez, Olga is joining us. Bonsoir Olga, comment ça va? Alors, Stardust reminds me of myself. Hey, you know what? One lesson without any problem, it's not a good lesson. We need to have at least one or maybe two problems like that. So let's have a look at the questions now. The first one, de quoi profite-t-elle? So you've been writing that quite well. Be careful, Vincent, de quoi profite-t-elle? Elle, hein? So in that case, it's the present form, so you don't need to put your A. De quoi profite-t-elle, hein? And then after that, de quoi est-ce qu'elle profite? D'accord? De quoi profite-t-elle? Second one, de quoi est-ce qu'elle profite? Allez, and that's it. Alors, le livre du jour, so the book of the day, it's Mariage gris, un cœur en enfer. So it's not olé olé, we won't laugh with it, well, we can laugh with anything in fact. Allez, Mariage gris, un cœur en enfer. So as usual, we will well discover the book in several points. I will read and try to listen to find the missing words. Laurent, la cinquantaine, dynamique, divorcé, recherche l'âme sœur. Sur Internet, c'est le coup de foudre pour Andrea. Elle habite Madagascar, certes, mais l'amour n'a pas de frontières. Laurent, la cinquantaine, dynamique, divorcé, recherche l'âme sœur. Sur Internet, c'est le coup de foudre pour Andrea. Elle habite Madagascar, certes, mais l'amour n'a pas de frontières. So try to write the missing words, please. Alors, let's have a look at the first one. It's cinquantaine. Hein? Remember to write it properly. So, c'est I-N-Q-U-A-N-T-A-I-N-E. La cinquantaine. Hein? Remember, cinquantaine, it's to talk about the 50s. Hein? Between 50 and 59. After that, it will be la quarantaine. Enfin, before that, it will be la quarantaine, la trentaine, la soixantaine, etc. Cosmina, c'est Laurent d'hier. Tu es en série avec les formes égorgées. Ah non, ah non, non, non! Ça n'est pas toujours les hommes qui blessent les autres, et ça peut être les femmes aussi. The second thing is foudre. Foudre, for your information, is in fact a feminine noun. La foudre. So you write it F-O-U-D-R-E. And so after that, it's the verb habiter, regular verb from the first group. And in that situation, you need to conjugate it in the third person of the singular. Habite, H-A-B-I-T-E. Allez, on continue. Non, 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 c'est pas Laurent, là. On y va. Après des mois de fréquentation virtuelle, puis dans la vraie vie,
Laurent se décide à épouser Andrea car il la veut à ses côtés chez lui en France. Après des mois de fréquentation virtuelle, puis dans la vraie vie, Laurent se décide à épouser Andrea car il la veut à ses côtés chez lui en France. Allez-y. Alors, let's look at the things. The first one is moi. Remember to write it properly because it's M-O-I-S. After that, virtuel. Virtuel, it's the adjective. In that case, we need to put the adjective in the feminine form because it's connected to fréquentation. Fréquentation is a feminine noun, but then it's plural in that case. So, virtuel will be written V-I-R-T-U-E-L-L-E. Don't forget the S for the plural. After that, it's épousé. That should be definitely in the infinitive form because the first verb, se décider, is conjugated. And after that, it's the second one. So it must be in the infinitive. E accent aigu, P-O-U-S-E-R. And after that, chez lui, hein, you will write it L-U-I. This one was, in fact, quite simple. Yep. It was quite good. Numéro 3, let's continue this interesting story. Et le drame commence. Du jour au lendemain, la jeune femme timide se change en arriviste impitoyable et révèle au grand jour ses véritables intentions. Obtenir des papiers français. Et le drame commence. Du jour au lendemain, la jeune femme timide se change en arriviste impitoyable et révèle au grand jour ses véritables intentions. Obtenir des papiers français. Écrivez les mots qui manquent. Can you write the missing words, please? Alors, yep, we were looking for four things. The first one is the verb commencer from the first group. In that case, you conjugate it in the third person of the singular, commence, C-O-M-M-E-N-C-E. After that, it's an adjective. The adjective is timid. Same thing here. Adjective should be the same in the masculine and in the feminine form. Here, it's the feminine and it's written T-I-M-I-D-E. Timide. Fourth thing is jour. Un jour, remember that it's a masculine word. Un jour, le jour. And you write it J-O-U-R. And the last thing, it's papier. Alors papier, you can see that it's in the plural form. And if you look carefully at the adjective français, you can see that in fact it must be masculine. Un papier. Here it will be the plural form, des papiers, P-A-P-I-E-R-S. Allez, on continue. Let's look at number 4. Elle ne reculera devant rien, allant jusqu'à le faire interner. Pour Laurent, c'est le début de la descente aux enfers. elle ne reculera devant rien, allant jusqu'à le faire interner. Pour Laurent, c'est le début de la descente aux enfers. S'il vous plaît, écrivez, write the missing words, please. Alors, Johanna, jusqu'à maintenant, j'adore votre leçon d'aujourd'hui. La musique est tellement inspirante et entraînante. You can try to dance at the same time, Johanna. I'm not sure if it's possible. And you need to type at the same time. Alors, on regarde ensemble. Let's have a look at the things. The first one, devant. Well, you write it quite well. So, let's see. Oui, D-E-V-A-N-T. Hein? So, that was the first word we were looking for. I'm not really sure because somebody has been putting... Ah, Baker, début. No, it was devant. So, after that, it's the verb. The verb is interner. Interner is, in fact, in that case, in the infinitive form I-N... T-E-R-N-E-R, d'accord? And after that, it's début, substantive. So in that case, you can see that it's masculine, début, D-E, accent aigu, B-U-T, d'accord? Allez, let's continue. The tragedy is not over. Un mariage qui s'avère une arnaque. Victime d'un sordide coup monté, Laurent prend la plume pour se défendre. Un mariage qui s'avère une arnaque. Victime d'un sordide coup monté, Laurent prend la plume pour se défendre. Write the missing words, please. Sorry, it was my mistake. Alors, Ice Cube, notre caractère, Laurent, d'hier était mieux. Ben non, Ice Cube, he was a serial killer yesterday. Well, at least now there is nobody dies. Alors, on y va, let's have a look at the things. I didn't know why the screen didn't change, in fact. So the first word was mariage. Remember that in French we've got only one R, d'accord? So M-A-R-I-A-G-E. Second thing, it's victim. Victim, remember that this noun can be masculine or feminine. It will be exactly the same form. So whether it's masculine or feminine, it will end with E, remember? So une victime. I mean, we talk about a person, but the noun in itself is only feminine. Huh? So victim, in that case, V-I-C-T-I-M-E. a, d'accord? But you can use it as an adjective. Il est victime, elle est victime. This is the reason why. Ice cubes, le text should be on your screen now, I guess. Hein? D'accord? But for the noun, it will be only feminine. And then the verb prendre is the last thing that we were looking for. And it's conjugated, obviously, in the third person. So it's P-R-E-N-D. Hein? Remember, prend. You don't pronounce the final D. I can read it one more time with the words. So, un mariage qui s'avère une arnaque. Victime d'un sordide coup monté, Laurent prend la plume pour se défendre. Allez, let's have a look at the last thing, and I hope it's showing. It's really strange why it didn't go the way I wanted to. But it's the last one, this one, so on y va. Incroyable, mais vrai. Un récit âpre et terrible de ce qui devient un phénomène de société, les mariages gris. Incroyable, mais vrai. Un récit âpre et terrible de ce qui devient un phénomène de société, les mariages gris. Allez, write the words. Shirley, it's retribution for all the murders he's done. He's got to pay. He's got to pay at one point, this Laurent. Alors, obviously, the first word that you can see is my favorite, and it's incroyable. So you write it I-N-C-R-O-Y-A-B-L-E. D'accord? Then after that, it would be terrible. Terrible, remember that we put two R, donc T-E-R-R-I-B-L-E. And the last one is phénomène. Phénomène, so don't forget that the first will be with accent aigu, and then the second one will be with accent grave. So P-H-E, accent aigu, N-O-M-E, accent grave, N-E. Phénomène. Voilà, merci beaucoup. Alors, let's continue with les homophones. Remember, we've been starting this series, earlier. So, les homophones, clearly, so we've been seeing that, so we know what it is. We pronounce them the same way, but then we write them differently. So, obviously, it means that we're talking about different words. The meaning will be different, d'accord? But then the sound will be exactly the same. In that situation, I will give you two. Let's start with the first one, and then I would like you to translate that into French. The flesh, how can you translate that into French? Go for it. MNM19, je kiffe les homophones. Wesh, wesh. Alors, je regarde. Oui, d'accord. We agree that what's coming and what I can see is quite good. In fact, it's la chair. So you write it like that. C-H-A-I-R. D'accord? La chair. So now we agree that because we're talking about les homophones, the next word that I will ask will be clearly pronounced the same way, but will be written differently. This is the concept. So now let's see the second one. And the second one should be the translation for expensive or dear. D'accord? How could you say that? Bickert, she's got to go. Au revoir, Bickert, et à bientôt. Alors, bonjour, wap-do-wap. Look at the dictionary, it's wap-do-wap, wap-do-wap. Voilà, donc effectivement, so in that case, we've got two options. We've got whether the masculine form, basic form, C-H-E-R, or then the feminine form, which is the evolved form, in a way, it's C-H-E, accent grave, R-E. Okay, so masculine form, C-H-E-R, feminine form, C-H-E, accent grave, R-E. And in fact, as you can see, these three things will be pronounced exactly the same way. La chair, chair, or then chair, feminine form. Et voilà, and that's it. Allez, le film du jour, le passager de l'été. It was a special day today, and I'm not even doing that on purpose. You will think that it's on purpose, but it's not. It is not. So it will be le passager de l'été. First, I wanted to find another film that was Pollux, but then I thought it might be more interesting to have this passager de l'été. So let's start with the first thing. Hillary is leaving us. Au revoir, Hillary, à bientôt. En 1950, dans le Cotentin, Monique, femme de caractère, a la volonté de faire, a repris la ferme que son mari a quittée pour ne jamais revenir. En 1950, dans le Cotentin, Monique, femme de caractère, a la volonté de faire, a repris la ferme que son mari a quittée pour ne jamais revenir. Write the missing words, please. Alors, il y en a la chair. Oui, it's another option. I'm not carving. La chair, it's quite rare, in fact. We don't really use it a lot. So that's the reason why I try to only focus on the useful words. Alors, let's have a look. The first one is caractère. Remember that in French, we don't put any H, in fact. We write it C-A-R-A-C-T-E, accent grave, if you have that on your keyboard, R-E. After that, we're talking about a noun, and it's ferme. Ferme is a feminine noun, and it's la ferme, F-E-R-M-E. And the last one, it's jamais, the adverb jamais, jamais plus jamais, J-A-M-A-I-S. So let's have a look at the second thing. Now I'm checking on the other screen because I'm always stressed. Elle tiendra la ferme avec dignité, abnégation, oubliant sa beauté, sa vie, s'oubliant elle-même. Elle tiendra la ferme avec dignité, abnégation, oubliant sa beauté, sa vie, s'oubliant elle-même. Alors, let's have a look at the three things. The first one is dignité. Dignité is a feminine noun, la dignité. And you write it D-I-G-N-I-T-E, accent aigu. And remember, G-N-N-N-N-N-N, digni, digni, dignité. Then after that, it's beauté. Beauté is a noun and it's a feminine noun, la beauté. You will write it B-E-A-U-T-E, accent aigu. And the last thing is même, elle-même, M-E. If you've got this circumflex on your keyboard, please put it, M-E. M-E, accent circonflexe, M-E, elle-même. Remember, this circumflex really opens the sound, E-E-E, même. Allez, let's continue with this story. Numéro 3. Sa fille, Jeanne, institutrice au village, n'en a cure et ne rêve, elle, que de partir à la ville. Sa fille, Jeanne, institutrice au village, n'en a cure et ne rêve, elle, que de partir à la ville. Write the missing words, please. Alors, M. Dasterdli, not sure if I pronounce it properly, but I'm doing my best, is offering me enough to get a coffee. It's really, really nice. Merci beaucoup. And especially, I'm drinking a lot of coffee, maybe too much, but it's good for me. Alors, merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. By the way, I can see I didn't push you to click on the likes, and it seems that we will stay like that. We won't reach the 100, which is extremely strange. Alors, the three things that we're looking for. The first one is fille. Fille is a feminine noun, so that's the reason why we have the possessive sa. Remember, we put the possessive according to the word they are connected to. Hein? So fille, fée, F-I-L-L-E, une fille. Village. Village is a masculine noun. Un village. So keep in mind that une ville is feminine. It's bigger. Un village, smaller. And it's masculine in that case. So it's V-I-L-L-A-G-E. And the last thing is partir. Partir is, of course, a verb in the infinitive form. P-A-R-T-I-R. Allez, on continue. Jeune, belle, romanesque, ses yeux racontent déjà une autre histoire. L'affrontement avec sa mère est écrit en filigrane. Jeune, belle, romanesque. Ses jolis yeux racontent déjà une autre histoire. L'affrontement avec sa mère est écrit en filigrane. Allez-y.
Ice cubes, yeah, it's possible. On a quelques verbes. Well, right now I'm thinking only about one, so can and canné, but it's just a question of time. In fact, I didn't really think about that, but I will try to put that in my mind, and maybe I can make an exercise on that if I find enough words and verbs.
Alors, regardons ensemble, so let's have a look together. The first one is yeux, hein, remember that, un œil. So it's a tricky concept, because un œil, it's masculine, singular and masculine, but when you put that in the plural, it's les yeux. So the change in words is quite drastic. So, but anyways, in that case, it's masculine and it's plural, so it's written Y-E-U-X. Yeux, yeux, yeux. Jolis yeux, hein, you will make the connection between the two, une magnifique liaison. Then you have histoire, feminine noun, you can see that because it's une, after that you've got your adjective autre, and then histoire, H-I-S-T-O-I-R-E. And the last thing, it's a feminine noun, obviously, because it's mother, mère. You will write it M-E, accent grave, R-E. Allez, on continue avec la prochaine partie ici. La pharmacienne Angèle ne pense qu'aux garçons. Amie et confidente de Jeanne, elle accepte son quotidien avec son charme dont elle sait jouer. La pharmacienne Angèle ne pense qu'aux garçons. Amie et confidente de Jeanne, elle accepte son quotidien avec son charme dont elle sait jouer. Allez-y. Alors, oui, regardons ensemble. So let's have a look together at the three words that we're looking for. And in that case, the first one is the verb penser, regular verb. It should be definitely in the third person of the singular, P-E-N-S-E. Second thing is the verb accepter. Accepter is, in fact, exactly in the same situation. Verb from the first group, and then you conjugate that in the third person, because it's L-A-C-C-E-P-T-E. And after that, it's a noun, it's a substantive, and it's charme, as you can see. It's a masculine noun, le charme, un charme, and in that case, it's son charme, C-H-A-R-M-E. Charme, voilà. Allez, let's, I think it's the last part, in fact. Non, 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 because it's a long story. Joseph, commis de ferme saisonnier, arrive un matin à la ferme pour trouver du travail. Joseph, commis de ferme saisonnier, arrive un matin à la ferme pour trouver du travail. S'il vous plaît, écrivez les mots qui manquent. Write the missing words, please. Alors, oui, it's really good, in fact, félicitations. The first thing is, well, it's a noun and it's feminine, une ferme, for your information. You write it properly, so F-E-R-M-E. After that, matin, well, M-A-T-I-N, it was properly written for everybody, so it's quite good. And then travail, it's a noun, a substantive, so it's a masculine word, so it's T-R-A-V-A-I-L, remember, A-I-L in the end, I, travail, d'accord? And this is probably the last part, yes. Homme libre, personnage fort, fier, à la limite de l'arrogance, ancré dans les anciennes valeurs du travail bien fait. Il va bouleverser la vie de ces trois femmes. Homme libre, personnage fort, fier, à la limite de l'arrogance, ancré dans les anciennes valeurs du travail bien fait, il va bouleverser la vie de ces trois femmes. S'il vous plaît, écrivez. Alors effectivement, un grand merci à Cosmina pour permettre la fluidité du cours. Merci beaucoup. Alors, let's have a look at the three things that we're looking for. The first one, homme is obviously masculine. You write it H-O-M-M-E, un homme. After that, ancienne, remember that the adjective ancien should be, in that case, well, in the feminine form, because valeur is a feminine noun. And if you look carefully, valeur is in the plural form. So ancienne should be in the feminine plural, meaning you will write it with this N-E extra for the feminine form, and you put S in the end, A-N-S-A-N-C-I-E-N-N-E-S. Ancienne. And the last thing, it's vie. Vie, it's a noun and it's a feminine noun. And you write it V-I-E, la vie. Voilà, so this is le passager de l'été. I didn't see it. Apparently, the comments were more or less good, so I'm not really sure if it's a good movie, in fact. So I don't want to tell you to watch it, because I have no clue. I think that the story might be interesting, in fact. Alors là, so now you can see that there was some technical things going on. It's interesting. So something is going on here. Apparently my computer doesn't want to work anymore on that side. So wait a second. I will check what's going on.
Allez, maybe the computer wants to tell me, Vincent, you've been working for too long now. Yeah, but we won't reach, Cheryline, we won't reach the 100 during the live. I guess we'll get the extra likes after that with the people who will watch it later, but it's okay. It is okay. I just want to make sure, because Victoria Posse is here, comme Victoria est là, je sais qu'elle attend la recette. And I don't want to finish the thing before doing la recette. Allez, on va faire la recette. Let's hope it doesn't... but it was a test with these little videos included in the thing. So maybe it's a bit too heavy for the computer. I don't know. We'll see. La recette du jour. So let's have a look at the recipe of the day. La recette du jour, c'est... It's a classic. C'est un classique. I'm pretty sure that everyone can master it in a proper way. But still, let's have a look at la recette de la ratatouille. La ratatouille, c'est délicieux. I mean, it's difficult to really, really hate the ratatouille. Well, people can don't like it. I mean, it's possible, but it's strange. Les ingrédients pour la ratatouille. 2 aubergines. 2 courgettes. 2 poivrons, un rouge, un vert, 3 tomates, un oignon ou 4 petits oignons frais, 10 olives noires dénoyautées, 3 gousses d'ail, 6 cuillerées à soupe d'huile d'olive, sel, poivre et du thym. D'accord? Alors, we'll start with the first step. And once again, we'll see if the machine wants to share the recipe with you or not. On y va. Laver les légumes. So everything will be in the infinitive as usual. I mean, so far, we've been doing the recipe with the infinitive, and I think it's better. Laver les légumes, couper les aubergines et les courgettes en tranches un peu épaisses, 1 cm, dans le sens de la longueur et sans les éplucher. Laver les légumes, couper les aubergines et les courgettes en tranches peu épaisses, 1 cm, dans le sens de la longueur et sans les éplucher. Allez, write the missing words. Alors, for this one, yeah, I wanted to cover the word aubergine. So, aubergine in that case should be in a plural form. For your information, it's feminine. Une aubergine, and you write it A-U-B-E-R-G-I-N-E-S. The other thing that is important is courgette. Courgette, also feminine, remember that. Well, in that case, it's the plural form. So, c'est O-U-R-G-E-T-T-E-S. And the last thing, it's longueur. Longueur, remember that it's a feminine noun. And you write it L-O-N-G-U-E-U-R. La longueur. Allez, let's have a look at the second step. Deuxième étape, on y va. Détailler ensuite ces tranches en bâtonnets de la même épaisseur, 1 cm. Coupez ensuite ces bâtonnets de façon à vous retrouver avec des petits cubes de légumes. Détaillez ensuite ces tranches en bâtonnets de la même épaisseur, 1 cm. Coupez ensuite ces bâtonnets de façon à vous retrouver avec des petits cubes de légumes.
Allez-y, s'il vous plaît, write the missing words. Alors, in that case, the first word that we were looking for was épaisseur. Épaisseur, hein, as you can see, it's a feminine noun too. You write it E, accent aigu, P-A-I-S-S-E-U-R. Épaisseur, attendez, I need to click on... Excuse, it's because you've been putting the cube. I don't know. It was blocking you. I had to unlock. After that, the verb is retrouver. Remember, it's se retrouver. So the pronoun is transformed with the vous, but then the infinitive is still R-E-T-R-O-U-V-E-R. And the last thing, it's cube. For your information, as you can see on petit, it's a masculine noun. Un cube, but in that situation it's plural, so you put S in the end, C-U-B-E-S. Allez, let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, and now I know exactly what I will cook today, it will be definitely that. Vider les poivrons de leurs graines, les tailler en lamelles, puis en morceaux, pour vous retrouver avec des morceaux de forme à peu près identiques à ceux des courgettes et aubergines. Vider les poivrons de leurs graines, les tailler en lamelles, puis en morceaux, 1 cm, pour vous retrouver avec des morceaux de forme à peu près identiques à ceux des courgettes et aubergines. Écrivez les mots qui manquent. Write the missing words. Alors, regardons ensemble les trois choses qui manquaient. Poivrons, so I just wanted to cover and to make sure that you can write, I mean, these things that are important for it. So, P-O-I-V-R-O-N-S, for your information, poivron is masculine, un poivron, but in that case, it's plural. Then, graine, graine, it's a feminine noun, une graine, same thing here, it's plural, G-R-A-I-N-E. S. And then identique, because it's connected to forme, hein, remember, it's not really connected to morceau. Well, it could be discussed in fact, but normally it should be connected to forme. So you won't put the plural form and you will write it I-D-E-N-T-I-Q-U-E. Identique, whether it's masculine or feminine, it will be written exactly the same way. Sherilyn, 6 more likes. We won't make it, Sherilyn. But it's okay. It is okay. I will cry right after. I will stop the thing and after that I will cry like a baby. Allez, on continue. Numéro 4. Numéro 4, on y va. Procéder de la même manière pour les tomates. Au final, vous vous retrouvez avec plein de petits cubes de légumes. I don't know why there is the... Here, it shouldn't be here. Procédez de la même manière pour les tomates. Au final, vous vous retrouvez avec plein de petits cubes de légumes. Allez-y. I told you
that he would come. Allez, va-t'en. J'arrive.
I knew that at one point. Ferme la porte, s'il te plaît, Nicolas. Merci. So, let's have a look at the thing. Well, I've got to feed him soon, so we'll finish the la recette, and after that, I will let you go. First thing is manière. Manière, it's a feminine noun, so in that case, la manière, you write it M-A-N-I-E, accent grave, R-E. Manière, then after that, you put tomate. Tomate, for information, it's a feminine noun, une tomate, but it's in the plural form now, merci. T-O-M-A-T-E-S. And the last thing, it's légumes. And légumes, you can see that you should put that in the plural form. So L-E, accent aigu, G-U-M-E-S. Voilà. Allez, let's finish as fast as possible because I'm pretty sure that he will come back. Trancher finement l'ail et les olives noires. Détailler en petits morceaux l'oignon, puis mettre l'huile d'olive dans une sauteuse et faire revenir tous les légumes à feu moyen. Trancher finalement l'ail et les olives noires. Détailler en petits morceaux l'oignon, puis mettre l'huile d'olive dans une sauteuse et faire revenir tous les légumes à feu moyen. Allez, write the missing words, please. Ice Cubes va chanter La vie en rose. Quand il me prend dans ses bras. You've got to roll the air a bit. Hein. Alors, let's have a look at the thing. So first, it's ail. Remember, it's a strange word because you write it A-I-L, but in fact, you really pronounce like ai, ai, ai. If somebody is hurting you, then you say in French exactly the same sound, ail. So the other thing, it's olive. Hein? Olive, remember that it's a feminine noun, so une olive, in that case, it's plural, so you need to put S in the end, O-L-I-V-E. S. And the last thing, it's huile. Huile, for your information, it's feminine. Une huile. And then you write it H-U-I-L-E. Une huile. Allez, let's continue with numéro 6. Numéro 6, and it will be the last step. Salé. Poivrer, ajouter le thym et faire mijoter à feu doux. Couvert, 20 minutes en surveillant que cela n'accroche pas. Servir chaud. Saler, poivrer, ajouter le thym et faire mijoter à feu doux. Couvert, 20 minutes en surveillant que cela n'accroche pas. Servir chaud. Allez-y. Regardons. So let's have a look at your things. Yeah, it's quite good. And so remember that the first is, in fact, the verb. The verb is salir. So actually, it's quite simple because it's a verb from the first group. And in the same logic, in the same way, poivre gives the verb poivrer. Poivrer, you will write it P-O-I-V-R-E-R. And then you can conjugate je poivre, tu poivre, il poivre, nous poivrons, vous poivrez, il poivre. Same goes for salir. The second thing is le thym. Remember, it's a tricky one because you write it like T-H-Y-M, but you pronounce it thym. Un. It is really a nasal, so it goes there. Le thym. And the last thing is, in fact, the verb servir. That should be in the infinitive. Servir chaud. Voilà, that's it. Merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. It was a bit strange today. Maybe it was because it was the 1st of April. Well, I had really a great time with you. Merci beaucoup. Merci. I invite you to walk with me. And I'm pretty sure that you won't find a place. I am pretty sure. If Yossi is here... Well, let's see, because when I film, of course, I film everything, so probably you can find it. Let's try to see if you can find it. So it's a city, it's an old city, and try to find a place if it's possible. On y va. Yossi, dans quelle langue Nicolas préfère parler avec vous, français ou finnois? No, it was always like that, Yossi. It's I'm only using my language, so I'm talking French to Nicolas, and this is the way it goes, and this is the way it went with Yasmin. Everyone, his own language. This is the way it goes. But Nicolas used to be a bit, bit more lazy than his sister. So because he knew that I could manage in Finnish too, he was putting some Finnish words. But now almost never. So. It's just only speaking French to me. Voilà. Merci beaucoup, Yossi. Try to find the place. We'll see. C'est pas sûr.